إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل كما جاء في محكم التنزيل يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Dear brothers and sisters, we always begin with praise and gratitude. Gratitude is the expression of recognition of favor. And so we are existence, everything we have in it, from the moment we were born, from our parents caring for us and making sure we had everything we needed, that we were healthy, that we were safe, that we were clothed, that we were fed, and the countless favors that we're surrounded with throughout our lives is a requirement that we live a life of gratitude to the one who gave us all of those things. And so that is what Islam is all about. That is the straight path that the prophets came to clarify. So we seek to follow those prophets, and we know the final of which was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And so we follow his example of true devotion to the one and only God that created everything and sent him and gave him the miraculous life that he led. I want to take you on a journey that if we have our hearts in yearning and longing for it, then this life will go by very quickly and you will feel a sense of tranquility. If we look in the Holy Quran and we look in the verified authentic hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it tells us what is to come. Just imagine that your time comes, however it comes, whenever it comes. Your time could be today, it could be tomorrow, it could be 50 years from now. None of us know when our time will come. But that time hits us and we look up and we see this light. So you're looking at this light and you see some angels coming out of this light. And one angel comes to you and asks you for your soul. Oh, good person, give me your soul. And you are in a state of warmth and comfort that you don't even realize what you've just left behind because of who you are. Your soul comes out of your body like a drip of the water coming out of a water skin that was turned over with the lid open. And so this angel has this beautiful glowing garment that he will take you in and wrap you up. And immediately as you are wrapped up in this blanket, you smell a fragrance better than anything you've ever experienced. You feel a warmth and comfort like nothing you felt before. And this angel takes you up with the other angels until you reach some gates. And these gates are guarded by angels. They said, "Who is this person?" And this angel of death who has you in this warm, comfortable, beautifully fragrant garment. And he says, "This is so-and-so, the son or the daughter of so-and-so, the righteous good person." And they say, "Glad tidings, open the gates," and then you will go up and this angel will take you up six gates in which the same thing will happen. Until you get up to the seventh gate and you see this beautiful light protruding, coming forth from above. And then this angel calls out, "I have brought you the soul of so-and-so, son or daughter of so-and-so, the righteous person." And then God will call out, "This is my servant with whom I am pleased. Write my servant among those of the people of heaven. But now take that servant back to the earth, because from the earth I created them, and I bring them out from it once again, after I return them there from now. So then the angel takes your soul down to your body in the grave, and puts your soul back into your body. And as you're sitting there, two other angels come to you. And these angels come and they ask you, O servant of God, who was your Lord? And then you answer, Allah, with all comfort and confidence. They ask you, what was your religion? How did you live your life? You say, Islam, submission to the Lord of the universe, with clarity and confidence and comfort from the depth of your soul. They ask you, who was this man who was sent to you? Muhammad. And then you will say, he was the messenger of Allah. And then God will call out, my servant has spoken the truth. Open up an expanse of feeling of comfort and warmth for my servant. Let my servant see his or her position in the place of paradise. Give them the fragrance of the gardens of bliss. Let my servant feel what it will feel like to enter the gates of heaven. So you will remain in the grave, in this visions of bliss, this feeling of comfort, this feeling of purity and bliss, until a trumpet is blown. You will hear this trumpet blown, everything will come to an end, and you will hear a second trumpet. And then as you feel it, you've been feeling like you're just in a beautiful dream for this time before this moment, in which the day of resurrection is called forth. And you will feel your body alive again, and you will see that you were as you were before you passed on from this earth. And you will climb out of your grave, and you will walk forth. And as you walk forth, you will see a beautiful, glistening water basin, and you will come forth and you will see the beloved chosen one, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he will be standing there smiling with the other believers, and he will call you, come forth. He will see you from the ablution that you have made shining forth from your forehead and your hands and feet, and you will walk up and he will say, have a drink. You will take some drinks from this water basin, and you will feel like it tasted like better than anything you ever tasted. And you will feel like your thirst is quenched, as though you would never need to drink again, but you drink again. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as all of the believers gathered around this basin, after they have all taken a drink, he calls out to his Lord, my Lord, this is my nation. Forgive all of them. They lived in servitude to you. They submitted their will to you. And at that moment, you will see coming down from heaven a book. And this book will come down to you in your right hand, and you will see it shining forth. You will look in that book and read, and you will read the beauty of sincerity and a life of devotion that you had led towards your Lord and Creator, Provider and Sustainer. So then, your spiritual weight and worth, based upon the actions and words that you have done, and the sincerity and the intentions behind them, that will all be weighed versus what shortcomings you had, And if you were of those who were fulfilling what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had claimed about you, all of those sins have already been erased by his intercession for you sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And so you're sitting there and you see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam march forth and you follow him. You're following the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and all of the believers, and you come to a place and you get scared because you see some darkness and some fire, and you see a bridge over this darkness and fire. You come there and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the first one in the line, and you look at yourself and you see light shining forth from your forehead and your hands and your feet. And you see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is like a glowing lamp himself standing in front. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam begins to move. And he prays to his Lord, give us a peaceful journey over this. Give us safety. Allahumma sallam, Allahumma sallam. So you follow him and you go over this bridge. And you find yourself moving quickly with the light. It's very clear, it's very easy, it feels comfortable. You get over this bridge. And now you get to the other side. And as all of the believers have come forth, and all of the hypocrites have fallen in to be with those who have rejected God and His signs and His message, you come forth and you see in front of you gates. You go up to these gates and you see these angels standing there. These angels call out, peace, perfection, it is for you, O good soul. They speak to you directly, welcoming you into the eternal bliss. So as the gates open, and these gates are far and huge and wide, like 40 years the distance between them, and you go in, the first thing that happens is the feeling. وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلٍّ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهِمُ الْأَنْهَارُ وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي هَدَانَا لِهَذَا وَمَا كُنَّا لَنَهْتَدِيَ لَوْلَا أَنْ هَدَانَا اللَّهُ وَنُودُوا أَنْ تِلْكُمُ الْجَنَّةَ أُورِثْتُمُوهَا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. At that moment when you walk in to the bliss, the first thing you will realize is the feeling of the burden lifted from within you. That was all that is bad in this life inside of you. Every one of us sitting here right now is afflicted with some sort of negative vibe. Some people are afflicted with arrogance. Some people are afflicted with jealousy. Some people are afflicted with hatred. Some people are afflicted with selfishness. Some people are afflicted with attachments to things that don't matter. And there's many things that we have inside of us right now that we need to be cleansed from us. All of that will be taken from you. All of the burdens from this life will be removed from you. And then it will be said, you will say, all praise be to God who has blessed us with this place. We could not have been guided if it wasn't for His guidance. And the messengers came with the truth. And now the angels will tell you, this is the eternal paradise of gardens with rivers flowing between them that you have inherited as a result of the work that you used to do in the life that you led. At this moment, it will be said to you, you enter as a good soul. You enter with peace and perfection for eternity. You are now worthy, O children of Adam. At this moment, from then on, there will be no sickness, there will be no sadness, there will be no poverty, there will be no responsibility, there will be no obligations, there will be no bodily harm or affliction or danger or fear. Nothing of the sort exists from there on out, because you have proved yourself worthy of perfection. You see, brothers and sisters, if it was me or you, we would have all ate from that tree in the beginning. We are here to prove that we are worthy to live there, because with our flaw and our imperfection, that there is no question about it, we have proved our devotion and gratitude to the one that has tested us. We wanted to be created, that's why we are all here. We are responsible in this life. So we go in to this paradise, and it's your world now. وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. You enter into a paradise that is extensive like a whole universe for your own. لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُونَ فِيهَا وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٌ. You will enter into this eternal abode of peace and bliss, and you get whatever you want. There is no limits. The levels of heaven is a place of respect, that we know that one is better than me. Everybody gets whatever their hearts desire. It's not like this one gets more than that up there. And actually, that feeling that you need things, it's not the priority in heaven. Right now, that is a disease we all have. I need stuff. I need the coolest stuff. I need the newest stuff. The nicest stuff. But as you will be the artist of your own universe and tapestry, to make as you like and do as you like, to join and take part in and invite family and friends and other people who are there into your canvas of your little universe, the most special thing that anyone has, as narrated by Imam Muslim, is النظر إلى وجهه الكريم ولدينا مزيد. You get whatever you want, and what's more than whatever you could want. And the Prophet ﷺ said, مَوْضِعُ صَوْتٍ فِي الْجَنَّةِ خَيْرٌ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا. The smallest little place, they used to hang up their little whip for their horse. The smallest little place in heaven, for one moment. A moment in heaven, in one spot in heaven, is better than the earth and whatever it had in it in riches and pleasures. But the best thing that's better than all of that is when you look up and you see the light of God. You will feel and embrace, and you will get lost in seeing Him directly. This is what we're all here struggling and striving to get. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه فإنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. The ayah said, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَىٰ مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. Hasten, hurry. In another ayah, compete, سَابِقُوا, to the forgiveness of your Lord, and a paradise, a heaven, that is like everything in the earth that you could have imagined just for you. And it is prepared for those who are mindful of their responsibility and the debt they owe to their creator, provider, and sustainer. We know from the Quran who is going to heaven. وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِنَ الصَّالِحَاتِ Whoever would work righteousness, those are going to heaven. What is righteous? It is intentions and actions put together. The intention that you have to do what you're doing, not worrying about what anybody in this world thinks. Not religious uncles, not mama and baba, not the people at school, not the people at work. You are simply concerned, am I cool and acceptable with the Lord of the universe? That's all you care about. So you do what you do knowing it pleases Him, and the reason why you know it's pleasing to Him is because you have lived a life of embrace to His holy scripture that He revealed and preserved, and preserved a detailed, expounded example in His messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You spend a lot of time reviewing yourself and reforming yourself, rectifying your intentions and your inner character and your outward character to the world around you, seeking that forgiveness for the shortcomings you will all have. So, but there is one thing that we came here to do, and we'll be joining again on January 5th. Many things the Prophet ﷺ said, if you do this, you're going to go to heaven. مَنْ بَنَى مَسْجِدًا لِلَّهِ بَنَى اللَّهُ لَهُ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ Whoever built a mosque for the sake of God so that His word could be elevated, so that the people who believe in Him could come together and piety and righteousness and virtue and integrity could be established and that the straight path is preserved. Whoever would build that, whichever amount of money you put in that, you will have a house built for you in heaven. We have two scholarly opinions on this one. The first one is, you can have whatever you want in heaven, so you can have as many houses, but Allah will build a special place that you will know as a result of that. Other scholars said, no, this is a metaphor, because obviously you can have as many houses as you want in heaven. They said, this is telling you that your home is being prepared in heaven. That's what you do with a house. You live in it. Your home, where you will live, is being established by this action. And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ رَاحَ إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لَهُ نُزُلَهُ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ كُلَّمَا رَاحَ أَوْ غَدَى إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever would go to the mosque, the place meant for him to be remembered and glorified and his word to be lived and promoted, whoever would go there, then their place in heaven is being preserved. Brothers and sisters, you are not sitting in a mosque. You are sitting in a Montessori school, being rented. It is our responsibility to build our mosque, which is our ticket to heaven. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to open our hearts, to fulfill our responsibility, that our ultimate priority is to please You, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, I ask You to guide us all to live in Your light, to soak up Your message and Your revelation, and to teach the values and character of Your beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Allah, enrich us, make us great, give us dignity through the message You have revealed to us. Ya Allah, make us leaders of the righteous, people whose example will be appreciated and glorified because of Your guidance. Ya Allah, unify our hearts for Your sake. Give us the means that we can stay steadfast on our way back to You as You have promised us. Ya Allah, help us realize that this life is temporal. It is not going to remain. The attachments of what lives here is not eternal. Ya Allah, help us to realize what is eternal in Your presence and make that be our eternal abode. Ya Allah, help us to be of those who are sincerely seeking Your guidance, repenting and seeking Your forgiveness when we slip up. Ya Allah, help us be a community that can be an example and lead and bring up a nation of people who will solve the world's problems and remove tyranny and oppression that we see all around us. Ya Allah, we ask You to send Your peace and blessings and mercy upon Your final messenger, Muhammad, wa aqim as-salat.